different in person. Every single costume looks different than what you would expect in some way.
Key moments in a century of filmmaking are captured in this exhibition, which curators say is more about film than fashion. Lucy Cotter, Sky News.
The V&A, if you fancy it, in London. Coming up in just a moment here on Sunrise, the awards honouring the NHS's Caribbean and African migrant nurses. We'll be talking about that in just a moment.
I got a fix on the boat who shot us, sir. It's the Illinois.
Our own people tried to sink us?
Sam, is that you?
Whatever they say about me,
please believe in me.
We do not obey a government that tries to murder its own. We need to change the game.
Brand new drama, Last Resort, starts Tuesday the 30th of October on Sky One HD.
I remember her saying it was cancer. I sat there and I thought, they can't possibly be talking about me.
Who's going to win, Jenny?
I know.
I've met some wonderful people. Some of them are still with us. Some of them aren't. I think £2 a month is nothing. Without the money, how's the research going to keep going?
At the time I was in hospital, there was a lad who had testicular cancer. Unfortunately, his cancer was very, very aggressive and it took his life. That scared me more than anything. We're not asking much here, just a couple of quid a month. We're saving lives. How much more important can it be? Please call 0800 035 6000 and donate just £2 a month to Cancer Research UK.
I think I just took life for granted a lot before, and now I know that I'm basically lived on borrowed time. Donating £2 a month to Cancer Research UK is such a small amount, and it's helping invest in yourself and your family and friends' future. Sitting here living is every minute's worth it now. Please call 0800 035 6000 and donate £2 a month to Cancer Research UK. Thank you.
Last year, we helped 17,346 people swap wellies back to slippers when their house flooded and helped find alternative accommodation for those who needed it. And right now, we're offering all new customers up to 50% off contents when they buy buildings insurance, plus up to a further 20% off online. Take the direct line.
Hello again. Now, between 1948 and 1973, 100,000 nurses from the Caribbean and Africa came to work and train in the NHS. An award ceremony today will recognise the exceptional contributions of those migrants in building our present-day NHS. Well, we're joined by the founder of Windrush Nurses and Beyond Foundation, Bob Foster. Hi there, Bob. Also retired nurse Dr. Nola Ishmael, who was awarded an OBE in 2000. Greetings to you both. Bob, how would you sum up the contribution made by these nurses?
Well, the contribution made by them has been tremendous. Without them, we wouldn't have the facility we have today in the NHS. We do owe them a debt of gratitude because we started after the Second World War, where many of the young had actually been decimated in England, and they came over from the Caribbean and Africa latterly to help build this NHS.
And Nola, what's your experience of being in the NHS?
My experience has been truly, truly delightful and rewarding. I started off as a student nurse, and within 18 months I was promoted to be a unit sister, and I worked with different nurses from across the Caribbean, and in 1990 I became the first black director of nursing in London, which was quite a breakthrough. I then went on to work at the Department of Health. I went for 3 months and stayed for 10 years.
Wow.
So, and having been retired, I'm now back in the NHS working.
So what was it like initially? I mean, you're saying that they first came over in 1948.
Yes.
It must have been a complete culture shock to nurses like yourself, and also to the residents of the country.
Indeed. The fog was different. The working, getting up early in the morning to get on duty at 7:30, working through breaks, doing double shifts. It was a very intensive period, but we enjoyed it. And we learned a lot from each other, and we had good memories, most of us anyway. I was one of those people that had learning as a passion.
Bob, we say there's an awards ceremony this evening, so what sort of stories will you bring to the awards ceremony of the experiences?
Well, we have the awards ceremony this evening at the Intercontinental Hotel Park Lane, we hope to bring the stories of people that came over on the boat earlier on, and to show them that what life was really like for the nurses when they actually came and did their training. And it was great fun coming from the Caribbean to England. I very much thought it was going to be a somber affair, but it certainly wasn't. The average age was 19, and if you can imagine, there were young men and women leaving the Caribbean for the first time and coming to England. And they met each other on the boat, and some stories were that eventually they got married once they got here. So it was a really exciting time for them.
And is it a generational thing? Have you found people who made that journey and set up their lives in the UK, worked in the NHS, and now other generations of those families are now pursuing careers in the NHS?
Absolutely. I mean, you know, their mum came, and then today daughters, grandchildren have actually taken up the baton, if you like, and have stayed within the NHS, because there are lots of families like that, and we hope through these awards that we will show this. And the real essence of it, really, along with my co-founder Sandy Phillips, we are actually going out into the schools to energize them again and say, well, look, this is a worthwhile profession. It happened before, so let's go out and do it. We have the backing of government. We also have the backing of all the associations who have been tremendous for us. And I have to say that this foundation wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for those retired nurses that gave their time tirelessly to help us put all this together.
Well, good luck. Hope you have a good night tonight. Thank you for coming in and sharing your stories. Bob and Nola, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Charlie has joined us, as you can see. The sports update. Hi, Charlie.
Hi, Lorna. Morning to you. South Yorkshire.